The original Swan Falls power plant was built more than 100 years ago. It became a source of electricity for southern Idaho mines and eventually went into retirement as a museum. Recently, it became home to some unique visitors.
I received a call a few months ago that we had a problem with bats at the Swan Falls Dam.
The commonly known Myotis lucifer, little brown bats to be exact.
We had a substantial amount of bats inhabiting the lower portion of the museum. Some folks were complaining about the smell, that sort of thing.
This wasn't just a bunch of bats hanging out at the museum, but a maternity colony. The female bats have come here to give birth to their pups. They're in an area of empty concrete chambers beneath the museum, where visitors come and go without ever knowing that the bats are there.
Because it was such a substantial colony, and it was a maternity colony, that we didn't want to necessarily exclude the bats. They weren't hurting anything. Nobody can really access that area down there, so they're somewhat protected.
Sandra asked Idaho Fish and Game biologist Rita Dixon to come take a look at the colony. Rita was very excited.
I'm happy to say that I love bats.
Hey, and what's not to love? They're cute little debuggers. And contrary to popular belief, these bats are not blind.
They have good vision, but their vision isn't very good in bright light. Their vision is much better in dim light.
Rita and Sandra are wearing protective clothing, not to protect them from the bats, but to protect the bats from them.
Looks like it's six.
A disease called white nose syndrome is responsible for killing off millions of little brown bats in the eastern United States. So Rita is looking for signs of the syndrome in these bats.
And so this is an ideal situation in proximity to good foraging habitat, and so it's important that we try to maintain places like this for bat colonies. In terms of our economy in not only Idaho, but this whole country, bats are extremely important to the agricultural industry and the forest industry and their consumption of insect pests.
In Idaho each year, it is estimated that bats provide the agricultural industry with $313 million in services through the insects they consume. As day turns to night, and with the help of an infrared camera.
There's gotta be hundreds in there.
Oh yeah, easily.
You can see how active the bats are as they feed on the nighttime insects. The bat droppings, or guano, will be cleaned up later this fall after the bats have left to hibernate for the winter. Reporting for E! News,
wow, there are a lot of bats.
I'm Lon Van Wyk.